I'd like to wish everybody at Berean Baptist a happy new year. We're fast approaching the coming of a new year for the glory of God. It's hard to believe that 2014 is coming to an end and that 2015 is right around the corner here. I look back at this last year and it's been a year of many blessings, many special visitations from the Lord. I have felt that our worship has been pleasing to the Lord. We've had some wonderful services. I'm so pleased with the spirit in our church, the unity and the love that we have amongst one another. Recently, there was a young man in our church who came to know the Lord, and his testimony to me was that the love of the people at the church shown to him was a great testimony to him, and it was the kindness and the love of so many people that opened his eyes to the glory of Christ and brought him to a saving relationship to Jesus. I rejoice in testimonies like that, and there's been many other outcries of blessing, many displays of God's grace upon the lives of our people. We've had a number of people who've lost loved ones this year, and the tremendous outpouring of kindness and love to those who have gone through sorrows and sufferings has been amazing. I had an unusual circumstance this year. As you all remember, in early July I had a tragic accident here in my home. I fell, damaged my knee severely, severed all the tendons and the quad muscle completely from my knee. I had to have reconstructive surgery, and I was out for about 4 months where I couldn't walk or bend my knee at all. When I look back at that, at the agony, the pain, the rehabilitation and the surgery and all that took place, it's hard to believe that I came through that, and by the glory of God, I rejoice and give Him praise. Looking forward to a coming year. In the new year, we have immediately coming up, Beto and Carlos from Brazil are coming. These are two brothers in Christ that have been such a blessing to our church in the times past when they've been among us. Looking forward so much to have them with us in the first week of February. Dewey Haim is going to be with us this year. He and Mari are coming over, and I'm looking forward to having time with them. And again, the home meetings and the fellowship times we have as they open the Word of God. Dewey is a choice servant, and whenever he opens the Word of God, it's a rich blessing to our heart. We also have Jerry Marcelino with us at our men's retreat coming up in February. I'm looking forward to that. Jerry's a dear man of God, a dear brother in Christ. I know our men are going to be richly blessed by that. There's many things coming up this year. I know we're going to have a number of special activities, a number of special events for our church, and my prayers that we'll have the blessing of God upon us. I'm looking forward to this coming year. I'm praying that it might be the best year we've ever had at Berean. We've gone through a lot of things in the last number of years, but God has been good. He's been gracious. And the gospel of Jesus Christ has been so enriching and comforting and such a blessing to our hearts. As we come to the end of this year, 2014, I want to thank the Berean family for your kindness to me during that time when I was convalescing and healing from my knee, from the surgery. I received many cards, a number of visits, a lot of poured out love by many people, showing their kindness and their love for this unworthy minister. I want to thank our Berean family for that. I want to thank all of you for your prayers. I want to thank you for your continued support. I want to thank you that you uphold me in prayer and my family in prayer. As the pastor of this church, there are many burdens that sometimes no one knows what pastors carry or what they face. The burden of the ministry is 24/7. It's around the clock. Our work is never done. We can never be able to say we've prayed enough, witnessed enough, served enough, labored enough. There's always something to be done in the kingdom work for God's glory. Keep me in your prayers. May the Lord sustain me, and I pray that I might be faithful to Him. Coming to the end of my life, I know that. I know the years are numbered, and I want to be faithful. I want to end on a high note, giving glory to God. One verse I want to share with you as we end this year, it's Micah chapter 6, verse 8, one of my favorite verses. A great verse to end this year on, and a great verse to look forward to in the coming year of 2015. The prophet Micah, as God speaks to him, says, "He has shown you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God." That's my desire for my life. I want to do justly, I want to love mercy, and I want to walk humbly with my God. And I pray that that will be the desire that you each have as well, that you'll be just, good, and kind to one another, that you'll be full of mercy, that you'll be full of tenderness, approachable and gracious to one another, and that you would walk humbly with the Lord, obeying His laws and His commandments, and displaying the love of Christ, the fruit of the Spirit, in all that you do. Well, God's blessed us at Berean. We're not a perfect church. I'm not a perfect pastor, but we are people who have been washed in the blood of the Lamb. We've been covered by the righteousness of Christ, and our peace and our joy and our hope is not in what we've done. It's not in what we feel or do, but all of our joy and our glory is found only in the finished work of Jesus Christ our Lord. May God give us a great year. May He smile upon us. May He help us to rise up as an army of believers, walking humbly with God, serving Him faithfully, with our eyes on the cross, with our eyes on Christ, with our eyes on glory, seeking to magnify and to glorify the Lord Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless you. May this coming year be the best ever for your family and for your personal walk with God. God bless you. I look forward to seeing you in the new year.